Muchísimas gracias, consejera, por hacernos viajar por todo el recorrido que nos ha llevado a este momento actual y también ver lo que viene en el futuro. Y esto ya habéis visto que no es un amor a primera vista, sino que ha sido una relación cultivada y que hay mucha esperanza puesta en ella, porque es mucho lo que tenemos que ganar. ¿Qué vamos a hacer ahora? Nos hablaba la consejera de ese proyecto, de ese trabajo en red que cuenta con la financiación de la Unión Europea, también de los fondos Next Generation y que especialmente estaba centrado tanto en la infancia como en las familias, pero que sus resultados son extrapolables a otros muchos ámbitos y por eso nos va a interesar tanto escucharles a quienes han formado parte activa de ese proyecto. Es el de trabajo en red con enfoque dialógico. Les voy a invitar a quienes nos lo han de contar a que suban al escenario. Luis Campos, por favor. Heikki Ervast, Jiuka Hakola, Katri Kuusela, Outi Kuwapi, por favor, al escenario. Ahora, una vez que se ubiquen, ya sí que les presento en condiciones y trato de hacer lo mejor posible con mi finlandés, que lo tengo oxidado. Dios mío. Y hoy es buen día para ponerlo en práctica. Adelante. ¿Voy bien? Voy con el buenos días. Atención, ¿eh? Primero lo digo yo, luego lo dicen ellos. Juva Huomenta.
Yes.
Bien, luego lo repetís vosotros. Gracias. Vamos con Luis Campos, él es director general de Planificación, Coordinación, Evaluación e Innovación de Políticas Públicas de Gobierno de Navarra. Va a ser quien va a liderar este diálogo. Contamos con Heikki Ervast, es CEO en Dialogs Design Limited de Finlandia, por supuesto, y formador. Muchas de las personas que estáis aquí le conocéis bien, al igual que a Jiuka Hakola, que es formador de métodos dialógicos de trabajo y que nos acompaña. ¿Quiénes han evaluado el proyecto? Ellas. Contamos con Katri Kuusela, directora de Educación de la Universidad de Laponia en Finlandia, y Outi Kuwapi, que es coordinadora de los Servicios de Educación y Desarrollo de la Universidad de Laponia. Así que ellos, ellas nos cuentan este instante y los resultados obtenidos. Adelante, Luis.
Pues nada, buenos días a todos y a todas. Y lo primero de todo, dar las gracias por acudir a este congreso, que la verdad que nos ha sorprendido a todos la cantidad de gente que está hoy tanto presencialmente como en streaming en el congreso. Yo lo primero de todo, aunque la consejera ya lo ha hecho, a mí la verdad que no puede faltar, yo creo que me gustaría que le diésemos un fuerte aplauso tanto a Itziar Herrero como a Trini Sainz por el trabajazo que se han pegado durante todos estos meses, con todo el proyecto y con todo el congreso. O sea que Trini y Itziar, enhorabuena. Y muchas gracias por el trabajo, la verdad. Ya lo ha comentado la consejera, febrero de 2020, con su impulso, además con el impulso personal de la consejera, empezábamos con una pequeña formación, con Heikki y con Jiuka, con enfoque dialógico, una formación que nunca habíamos tenido en el Gobierno de Navarra, y a mí cuando me lo contó la consejera cuál era la estrategia, yo le dije, como siempre, Mari Carmen, voy a ayudarte, pero yo la verdad que no sé, de este enfoque de trabajo, esta metodología de trabajo no la conozco, pero encantado de ayudarte. Y empezamos con esa primera formación. Un mes después llegó la pandemia, todo se paralizó, pero después de la pandemia y gracias a los fondos Next Generation, tuvimos la oportunidad de escalar, de pasar una pequeña formación, porque había sido una pequeña formación de 3 días de duración, a un proyecto muy, muy potente, con un programa formativo, con un programa de formación de formadores y luego con una parte que también para nosotros era muy importante, que era la parte de la evaluación del proyecto. Que para nosotros, bueno, el poder contrastar los aspectos positivos y las líneas de mejora para nosotros era imprescindible, porque queríamos que este trabajo no fuese flor de un día, no fuese un proyecto aislado, sino que se convirtiese en una estrategia central del trabajo con las personas, no solo de un departamento, no solo del Departamento de Derechos Sociales, sino de más departamentos. Y ahora estamos aquí en la última fase de este proyecto europeo, con este congreso, que es el cierre, con un proyecto europeo Interreg que también tenemos en marcha, el proyecto NIER, que también tiene como objetivo el desarrollar y aprender nuevas metodologías de trabajo comunitario en el cual les pongamos a las personas en el centro. Y por delante todavía, y ya lo ha adelantado la consejera, una línea de trabajo muy importante para todo el Gobierno de Navarra, que creo que ya está dando buenos resultados, creo que está cambiando las metodologías y los enfoques con los que nos relacionábamos con la ciudadanía y por el cual vamos a tener durante los próximos años mucho trabajo que hacer. Tendrán que ir profesionales de Navarra a Finlandia a aprender in situ cómo se trabaja y aquí también tenemos que ser capaces de que las personas que se os vayáis formando en este enfoque y que lo vayáis utilizando, seáis capaces de trasladar a los compañeros y a las compañeras estas nuevas metodologías y enfoques de trabajo. Heikki Jukka, vamos un poquito tarde, vamos a intentar ya en esta mesa ajustarnos a los tiempos. Desde vuestra experiencia, a mí me gustaría, de forma distendida, ¿cuál ha sido vuestra impresión del trabajo que se ha desarrollado desde Navarra, desde el inicio, desde esas pequeñas primeras jornadas de trabajo y cómo habéis visto al Gobierno de Navarra, a todos los profesionales? ¿Cuál es vuestra sensación cuando habéis trasladado este nuevo enfoque de trabajo y si creéis que a partir de ahora vamos a ser capaces de asumir esta metodología como propia y abanderar el desarrollo de esta nueva forma de trabajar con las personas? Heikki Jukka, el que...
Buenos días. Buenas. Egunon. Buongiorno. Hyvää huomenta. Patricia, hyvää huomenta. Good morning. It would be a miracle if nothing happens because we have over 200 excellent trainees who know how to use dialogical tools, and this train has started running. You can't stop it anymore. So that's the answer. Okay, shall we sit here?
Jukka. Yeah. Okay. I think this has been very important experience for us too, because you told about the first meeting, first training we had. Left a very warm message to our heart, into our heart, and we said to each other, we want to continue, hopefully we can do it, and then it happened suddenly. It asked a lot of work, we realized, but then when we started this new process, the same idea continued in my thinking. I think it has been a great pleasure so far to meet all these beautiful people here in Navarra and see how things are going on.
Muchas gracias. Katri, Auti, habéis estado en el equipo de evaluación. Me gustaría saber cuáles son los aspectos positivos que habéis detectado del impacto de esta formación en los profesionales y en las posibilidades que tenemos de mejorar la atención a las personas, pero lo que me parece más importante de la evaluación, también que nos podíais trasladar qué líneas de mejora, aspectos de mejora, podemos desarrollar para ser más eficaces y eficientes en el desarrollo de este nuevo enfoque de trabajo.
Thank you, yes. I think the evaluation results are kind of amazing. They are really well, and the people have been committed throughout the process, and I have no fear that it won't be implemented in here. And some of improvement ideas just came right here into my mind is, I think there is a need to have a peer-to-peer conversation and go through with the processes and gain some more confidence on how to practice this dialogical approach. What about Odi? Do you have anything
else? I don't know. You had all the words.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we are going to give a presentation later on where we are going to discuss more about this.
Okay. Heikki Jukka, me gustaría que nos trasladaseis cuál es vuestra primera sensación la primera vez que vinisteis aquí
Jukka
a Pamplona. muchos de nosotros no sabíamos, muchas de las personas que participaron en la formación no sabían nada del enfoque dialógico. ¿Cómo percibisteis cuando empezasteis a comentar, a trasladar en inglés a un público que generalmente hablábamos en castellano esta nueva metodología y cómo, si habéis notado un cambio en la percepción de las personas que han participado, con las que ya lleváis unos años trabajando en su enfoque de trabajo?
A very concrete example, the decibel, the noise in the room when we started was here. And in the middle part of the training project, it was over here. And now it's over here. You could see also when people were coming here. It doesn't mean that we are training people to be like Finnish people who are not talking, but we are teaching people to listen and be calm, present in the moment. So there is a very concrete... I have shooted videos also about this.
And I have been thinking quite many years already that what is the meaning of culture, people's culture. Mm-hmm. And after this process, I would say there is only a minor differences between people. Because if I say something what is dialogical in Finland, it is good here as well. We understand each other when we are talking about dialogues. And we don't need to speak about differences. We can speak similarities. Mm-hmm. People are quite similar everywhere. And in my mind, it's quite strong thinking at the moment. Like Maria Carmen said in the first, this seems to be suitable, this Finnish dialogical approach here in Navarra as well. I agree.
Los problemas que os trasladaban los alumnos a los que se enfrentaban en el día a día eran muy diferentes a los problemas a los que se enfrentan los profesionales en Finlandia, o como habéis comentado, cada vez tenemos unos problemas similares en todo el marco europeo.
The issues are quite the same, but of course there are differences. Maybe they are cultural differences, but I have noticed both here in Spain and Italy that the people who are in dialogical training processes, they are very committed. And that's why these facilitators that have graduated, that they are very excellent. We are not worried. We say them in the end, jump into the river of dialogues, start swimming. They can do it. They are very good.
Están preparados ya. Teia Ruiz. Están preparados ya nuestros profesionales para aplicar el enfoque dialógico.
Yes, they are very good. They are ready. Just start doing.
Katri, Outi, ¿nos podríais trasladar la metodología de evaluación que habéis utilizado en este proceso? ¿Qué técnicas habéis utilizado de evaluación? Y luego, si habéis encontrado diferencias entre cómo abordáis la evaluación de un proyecto de estas características del ámbito social en Finlandia o cómo evaluamos aquí esas políticas de similares.
We used process-based evaluation and different kind of methods. This was quite a big evaluation process for us, and it differs in that. I think the similar kind of training process we would have in Finland, I think we wouldn't have so many evaluation methods and used techniques. We tried to put everything into it and use different kind of surveys, discussions, interviews, different kind of techniques, also kind of workshop related techniques. We got quantitative and qualitative data. And we will have a slide of it in our presentation, so we can go through it there also a bit more.
Okay. If you want to start with the presentation that you have.
Yes. Okay. Shall we sit here or do we stand up? Because we thought, because we have these microphones, that we are like ABBA, the new ABBA. can you put the slideshow on? Okay. We are talking now shortly about the training process, about how long did it take and which kind of groups we had. But before that, I'd like to ask you, Jukka, what did you learn during this process? Because this is a learning project.
Okay. Can't you ask something else, which is not so large question?
No.
Okay. I was learning quite soon that when we are in a dialogical process, there is a need of will. People need to want to do this dialogical way of doing things. And when there's a will, everything is easy after that. It has been very, very strong emotion to me. But same to you. What did you learn?
I learned all the names of the 95 facilitator trainees.
It's proved, yes.
Yes, because yes. When in a dialogue, when we are talking to other people, it's good that I can say I'm talking, what do you think, Sandra? What do you think, Pedro? Angela? Laura? Patricia? Jesus? It's good to have a connection also in that way. So this training process has been, yes, I was going to ask that, shall I use this one? To talk to a certain subject, not a trainee or an object. You know this. But maybe we'll go on with the slideshow. Quite quickly, don't worry. These slides are first in English and then comes the Spanish version, because we have to know what we are speaking. So our training process started in February 23, and now tomorrow it's ending. So it's a 1.5 year process, and as Maria Carmen said, totally 286 hours. And this training process was divided into two parts, the training project and the evaluation project, which Katri and Outi are telling about the results.
Quite many more hours on the top of that, because all trainees needed to work dialogically and have some real cases to train how to use these tools. That's a huge amount of hours what yes. has happened around this.
And Outi and Katri will tell more about the evaluation process, but some words about the training process. We had three different groups A, B and C. And group A was the facilitator training group, and group B was some kind of a general introduction to dialogical approach, and also to learn some dialogical meeting tools and so on.
Some of people joined in one of those groups, or two, or somebody maybe in three of those groups. So quite a deep understanding of dialogues you have already.
So, and the group C is the trainer's training, like this was mentioned by Luis earlier. So, in the group A, we had 95 participants and 210 hours of working in 10 modules. So it means that we work quite a lot of here in Pamplona. We know all the main, all the streets in the city center, and we know where is the Soto area and so on. So it has been a wonderful being here. During the facilitator training process, we created 11 natural networks, which were created by the trainees, and we asked them to create networks that are based on who are working with each other, which are the closest organizations, in which way could you cooperate the easiest way. So then 11 networks were created, and the meaning of this training was to have a capability of facilitate anticipation dialogue. So they are facilitators.
Main idea was to learn what is the good future dialogue in a client case. And when we did all that, then we started to learn what is the dialogue in a working context or in an area of living, or maybe in school context, everywhere people have their everyday life.
And then the group B that was done a year ago in the springtime 23, we had 100 participants, and it was a 30 hours training of basic things about dialogical approach, but also practicing some easy dialogical tools so that you could change the ordinary meetings which you are having in workplaces into a dialogical ones. And that happened in 4 modules.
And those people, we think, can support the facilitators' work. They can do what is important for bosses to understand and help these things happen. But it's not only one way, because facilitators can start helping administration people quite easily in their needs. So we need cooperation.
And finally, this springtime, we trained 42 new trainers for new trainees. So these 42 people who were in 42 hours of training are capable of training new facilitators, but in generally training and teaching about dialogical tools and ways of working in workplaces and so on, to spread dialogical approach. And for in this sense, the continuity is very important. We have now 48 excellent professionals who can continue training new people. And so in that sense, Navarra will be a very dialogical region.
Yeah. There wasn't a possibility to start a facilitator trainees course yet. It will happen. Trainers started by telling what is taking up one's worries and how we can have a public note in our meetings. Those basic ideas we need all the time when we have dialogues.
So everything started from this. Maria Carmen was giving an opening speech. And we have been asked many times, what are you doing in the dialogical trainings? So we are practicing how to listen, how to interview, how to be present in the moment, how to facilitate, how to take up difficult issues, worries, and so on. And for that purpose, it needs that we are in dialogues. It is the only way to learn dialogical approach, to take part dialogues.
And that is why we did all the time that first we had some kind of experiences. We leaded people to experience something what is dialogical. And then we started to talk about theory things. First practice and then theory. Maybe we heard somebody to say, let's do the theory first. We want more theory. But what happened? That is surprising. People said, don't do that because we don't need, we don't want theory. We want practice and we want to learn from that way. So it was very nice to hear that because we thought at the very first we have something to do in dialogically and then explain what happened.
So this is the result. Here are the new facilitators, and in this group there are also the new trainers, not the group B members because they finished a year ago, but I think that it would be a good idea, please, facilitators, stand up, we will give you an applause, and you who are at home, please stand up too. Stand up. So, at the end, I will say that because during the springtime we heard several questions about do we get some kind of document or dossier or whatever. Yes, there is now the Dialogical Facilitators Guidebook. It's already in SWAY, which is our own area, it's not a public area. You can download the Dialogical Facilitators Guidebook in Spanish, Basque and English versions. But they are not yet in the Gobierno de Navarra pages because I put the European Union logos in the wrong size and wrong place, so they must be fitted. But you can read the text. They will be the official versions on the Gobierno side.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's your turn.
So like in the ABBA, now the women split.
Okay. Go to you prefer it.
We can okay. Play piano here. Yeah.
You prefer it?
Yeah, we prefer this.
Okay.
Can we have our slides? Thank you. So, as you have heard, we are the evaluation team, and we come from the University of Lapland, that is in Rovaniemi, in north of Finland. We will present you a short overview of the results we have got, and we have committed a final evaluation report, and that is in Luis Campos and Itziar's hands soon, in Spanish next week. So if you have more questions, maybe you can contact them or us. Let's see. Yeah, this is our content of the presentation. Shortly, something more about our evaluation process. And then, as introduced by Heike and Jukka, Group A, Group B, and Group C's evaluation results and some final conclusions. I am very grateful to have been part of this process and of this methodology that is being introduced in a new way in Navarra. This is the one response that we got in the evaluation, one of the final evaluation survey, and this is a good one to describe the whole contentness of the participants in all of the trainees. We notice it in the right in the beginning of this cooperation. And here is the answer to Luis Campos' question about the evaluation process. So, of course, we do evaluation processes in Finland, and they are also long and thorough, but I think in here is something a bit, maybe something a bit extra, what we have done. We did an initial evaluation survey in start of every group, in Group A, Group B, and Group C, and then midterm evaluation, and then the final evaluation. In addition to those, we gathered continuous evaluation material throughout from the beginning of February 2023 and until April this year. We also have had evaluation discussion with some of the key persons here from the government, and we have got material from the target group. We have had material from our trainers, from our field work, and done the analysis all the time. We have committed a midterm evaluation report and now the final evaluation report. Here are some of the methods we have been using. So we had, we ask after each model, after each groups, each model, a feedback survey. And then also survey for employers in Group A's, the Group A's participants' employers. We sent a survey to get information what they think about the dialogical approach and about what are their main reasons for kind of letting people to attend this training. Then focus group discussions, different kind of interviews, and our observation during our field works and reflection and about these individual works. All in all, in surveys we have got 1,581 responses. We have interviewed 182 participants, and in individual workshops have been 77 participants. And Heikki and Jukka have written us reflections after each model, and those have been also included in the evaluation process. Evaluation criteria were relevance, efficiency, coherence, coverage, effectiveness, impact, sustainability, participation, and satisfaction. And now moving on to the results.
Yeah, we go first through Group A. And as already discussed, it was the longest training course that started last February and it ended this March. And there were 95 participants, and as there were 80% attendance requirement, 89 passed the course. And 74 of the participants were female and 26% male. And like Heikki and Jukka already said, that they had 10 models, included on-site and online training sessions and practical exercises and also these supervision sessions. And there were four objectives, and I think that these we have been going through already in previous presentations, so I will not discuss about them so much. But the main motivation for participation for the Group A participants were they wanted to have this personal learning experiences, improving the work with the customers and learning how to work efficiently in networks. And there were also discussion that the system here needs some change, and it was a motivational factor for the participants. Here's a picture of the overall satisfaction rate in all the models, and as you can see, the rates are really high. And throughout the whole evaluation material, both trainees and also trainers Heikki and Jukka, they were really happy how the training proceeded, and they described the overall atmosphere of the training course as really positive and also hopeful. And the method itself was seen as participative and very motivating for the participants. And how, as you can see, there's a difference between the online sessions and on-site trainings. And mostly the reason was the tool used during the sessions and other technical issues. And in the last phase of the training course, supervision groups were organized. And these were found really useful for the trainees, and they were satisfied working in small groups.
They described that the supervision session deepened the knowledge they had learned during the other training sessions, and the practical exercises of facilitation were more effective when they were done in small groups. And it also helped building the networks between other professionals. And other things, the most of the trainees mentioned that the best part of the training was inner growth and learning together with others. The training course helped the participants to learn a new way of human communication, to stop, think, listen, and reflect. They argued in the evaluation material that quite many times professionals seem to have a clear vision of how things should be handled, but the dialogical approach allows the professionals to take a step back and listen to the clients and give them a voice. And here's one note from in the final survey. All this learning I have been doing and the world of possibilities that it has opened up, learning from another perspective, finding the answers through my learning process. So the professionals learned new tools and through these practical exercises. And when they started practicing and using the methods, they noticed how effective the dialogical approach really is. And it gave the trainees self-confidence to try the tools out at their work as well. And the participants collected feedback from the meetings where they used dialogical approach, and the results from the field were really positive. The meetings were described very dynamic, effective, and participative, and the family members also said that there were more possibilities for discussion, and they really felt that they were listened to.
Okay, and then the group B's results. Well, we have heard that it was a much shorter training than the group A. It lasted 4 months last spring and had 114 participants, and 77 of them passed the needed attendance percentage. The difference in this group B was a bit with the backgrounds of the participants. There were also a lot of were working at the social working area or social educators and such, but also from the police department and from the university there were attendances, and also some of their participants were working as a director or those kind of tasks. 85% female, 15% male. The objective for the group B was, as Heiken Jukka already said, learning to use some of the tools and have support for having dialogue meetings with different individuals, families, and how to use it in work and create networks. The participants said in the initial evaluation that they wanted to learn a practical tool for daily work. They wanted to learn how to work in their work a more people-oriented way. And they also pointed out that they wanted to learn how to listen. And the results were good. Although it was a short training, the attendees said that it provided enough information and increased the knowledge, and the number of the practical exercises that was in the training was found positively. They thought that it would be more theoretical training, but it was maybe a good surprise, Heikki and Jukka, you have had. The training gave inspiration and the tools that was needed to renew their way of working, and also they found that, or said that this was a good first step to the social cultural change in the area. One said that it has helped me to grow personally and to feel prepared to accompany people in my immediate environment. And then moving on to the Group C training, that is, I think, essential for the continuity of this approach in here. So how to train the new facilitators. This started this year, also lasted 4 months. Initially, it was planned that there would be 17 participants in the Group C's training, but throughout the Group A's training, there was a great interest with the participants to get in the Group C, and then it was discussed and decided that let's take more people, and 48 participants were accepted. You had to have 75% of the Group A's training passed in order to get to Group C. 76% were female, 24% male. Also, this consisted of 4 modules, and online and on-site. And how to train new facilitators training had these objectives. So train and supervise new network dialogue facilitators, support peer learning and self-learning processes, and combine dialogic theory with the practices, and reflect on and evaluate practice processes in collaboration with trainees. We ask from these participants what were their main reasons for participating to this training, and there were three themes that aroused. One was deepening the knowledge about dialogical approach. Second one was an interest in sharing knowledge about the methodology with others in networks. And the third one was interesting and good that they had already noticed within Group A's training that the method has been found, was useful with their target groups. And the results were excellent. We always ask participants to give a grading on a scale 1 to 5, 5 being excellent, of this training, and this got 4.5 grading, and the content was 4.4. And the participants said that this really deepened and strengthened the Group A's training, and it gave them the confidence to use approach also in new contexts. They felt that now we are prepared to train, and one said that, I believe that I am ready to continue training myself and others. This training is helping me to change my beliefs and transform myself so that my professional work is also transforming along with my colleagues. And this continuing developing and continuity is an ongoing process that arouses also from the materials. However, there were still some, as I said in earlier, still a bit uncertainty also. Some people said that I'm content with the training, but I feel myself a bit unconfident. I noticed that I need more practice. And there was I believe that with time and effort, I could do it, but I am aware I still have a lot to learn from practice. And then the final conclusions.
Yeah, final conclusions from all three groups. First of all, to trainers' professionality, the trainees in all group, they were really satisfied with Heikki and Jukka's professionality. They were described as amazing, positive, patient, and truly professionals in this topic. And their teaching style was also highly appreciated, and it helped the trainees to learn. And these are comments from the... yeah. And like in the comments that are there, both are excellent teachers with a very good ability to transfer information. And the other one, congratulations to the teachers. They have energized a large group in an excellent way. We have learned and also had fun. And this was really visible when we were doing the field work that the respect that the participants had towards the trainers.
The model 5.
One exception.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. And also the results throughout the whole training process, they have been excellent. There were some special notes and improvement suggestions. And the pace and the calmness of the trainers aroused both positive and negative discussion in the material. The trainees described that the slow and calm pace of the training was something that they were not used to here in Spain. And they even called the way of teaching a lapis a slow rhythm. So that was the surprise I was going to tell you today. And one reason for that might be the way of doing the translation, but also it is a part of being dialogical, the doing things in a calm way. Also, the large group sizes, especially in group A and B, they caused some problems, especially concerning the venue. The room was quite small for group working. But also, this was seen as a positive aspect, as now there are so many people who know about the dialogical approach here in Navarra area. And the sessions were described as long, and some technical issues were in the online sessions, and the participants also wanted to have more time to practice in real life. And quite many were hoping throughout the whole training course to have some more instructions, real-life examples, videos, etc., and also a tool guide. But now, as we heard before, it has now been published and it will be distributed to you later on. Also, expanding to the other fields was suggested that it should be covered also other fields, and now we also heard that it's going to happen, so that's a good sign. And also, there were some room for improvement. It's a fact that the results of this training course were impressive. And it can be said that the dialogical approach has a good future in Navarra area. And since the beginning, there has been a high level of interest towards the dialogical approach. And now there are 257 trained professionals in all the corners of Navarra area, as you can see from the map. And they all have all gained knowledge, skills, and expertise in this dialogical approach. And many of the participants described the dialogical approach as a change of paradigm that also enabled internal change. And from our point of view, it has been amazing to follow the journey and the learning process of each participant and note the inner growth that you have had. You all trainees have been really enthusiastic, highly motivated, eager to learn more, and most of all implement this method to your daily work. However, the approach will not evolve without organizational support and coordination system, which both were highlighted in the evaluation material by the participants. And many of the trainees said that they need some support, such as supervised follow-up meetings with the trainees, opportunities to share experiences with other facilitators, and gain more confidence while using this approach and its tools. And this will ensure the continuity of this well-started way of doing things differently. And one participant said that we are promoting a change of model in the care of people, and this is a perfectly valid methodology to achieve this objective.
So at the end, we want to congratulate you all of the great job you have done, and thank you for the opportunity for us, for what we have with the evaluation process. Thank you.
Muchas gracias.